Okay, we're back for 1 o'clock with Coach Kathy and the crew for flag football. I hope you stay hydrated and stay healthy because this is a sport that's a little more strenuous and you want to make sure you're good and limber and don't get hurt during the sport. 3 o'clock, we have Coach Brooke today and some Soyos doing some healthy alternatives and snacks that you can make while you're at home. So everybody stay tuned then for evening entertainment with Maria.
Hi, Specialos! We're all in Michigan. We miss you guys so much. We miss the athletes, SOPA, Soyos. We miss everything. And we want to sing a few songs for you.
Oh, yeah.
I feel a breeze. Ooh, it's in my knees. Ooh, it's in my hips. Ooh, it's in my lips. Bang, bang, choo-choo train. Come on, Special O, do your thing. Get it, get it, get it, get it. Got it, got it, got it, got it. Whoosh. And let it roll. Whoosh. And let it roll.
Hi, campers. I'm Christina.
I'm Natalie.
And I'm Jacqueline. And we miss you all so much. We wish we could be together at camp this year, but unfortunately we can't. So we recorded this special and fun song for all of us to sing together. It's Baby Shark, and we hope that you guys all sing along with us. All right, let's get started. 3, 2, 1. Baby shark, doo 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 doo. Baby shark, doo 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 doo. Baby shark, doo 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 doo. Baby shark. Mama shark, doo 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 doo. Mama shark, doo 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 doo. Mama shark, doo 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 doo. Mama shark. Daddy shark, doo 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 doo. Daddy shark, doo 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 doo. Daddy shark, doo 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 doo. Daddy shark. Grandpa shark, doo 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 doo. Grandpa shark, doo 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 doo. Grandpa shark, doo 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 doo. Grandpa shark. Going swimming, doo 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 doo. Going swimming, doo 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 doo. Going swimming, doo 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 doo. Going swimming. Saw a shark, doo 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 doo. Saw a shark, doo 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 doo. Saw a shark, doo 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 doo. Saw a shark. Swim away, doo 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 doo. Swim away, doo 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 doo. Swim away, doo 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 doo. Swim away. Say that last you did it, did it, say that last you did it, did it, say that last you did it, did it, say that last.
Woo! Good job, everybody.
Thanks, guys. We miss you so much.
Love you a lot and wish we could be with you.
Everybody, stay safe, stay well, and enjoy this year's version of Sports Camp. We miss you.
Bye.
Bye.
Hey, welcome to flag football. This year looks a little bit different, I know. Usually my friends Melissa and Shelly and Neil and I pack up our suitcases, that's why Shelly's up there, and we drive 5 hours out to Antiochian Village for sports camp. This year we're going to be virtual, so all you got to do is log on. We shall see you there. Here we go. Now, you know, when you're at home, you probably don't have cones and pylons, and that's okay. We've used a bunch of different stuff behind us, and Neil is going to do the agility drill, and look, we don't even have a football. You can use, like, I don't know, pillow, whatever you've got around, and do the same drill, and you can have somebody else time it on their cell phone. So it works. So we're going to get ready and let Neil do the agility skill. Are you ready? All right, let's see your touchdown dance, Neil. You like one? Oh, that's your touchdown dance? Great job. Thanks, Neil. Okay, Nick, whenever you're ready.
I'm ready.
All right. Touchdown dance. That's awesome. We're back with Nick again, and this time we are going to film agility skill number 2, level number 2. This has got a lot more cones. It's got 12 cones to go around, and this time Nick is specifically going to work on doing like a good sidestep. So when you're ready. Good sidestepping.
That's right. Good job, Nick. This is why we hydrate people. Ooh, let's see that dance. And let's, there you go. Touchdown.
Hey, we're here with Neil, and Neil's gonna also demonstrate the agility drill. And Neil's gonna remember to do the side steps and go around on the outside of the cones, okay?
Yes.
You ready?
Yeah.
All right, where's your big Kansas City Chiefs smile? There you go. All right, ready, set. In, guys. Oh, this is in. In the pandemic days, we're like 6 feet apart.
Yeah.
Thank you for helping us with our drills. This is going to help a lot of our athletes to stay fit this summer. Neil, since we're out here doing football, do you have a favorite football player?
Yeah, Pat Mahomes and Tyreek Hill.
From the Kansas City Chiefs, like all your stuff. Yeah, good job. Mm-hmm. How about you, Nick? Who's your favorite player?
My favorite player would be Matt Collins.
Who?
And Carson
Wentz. Good job. Thank you for doing our drills.
All right.
Hey, Coach Troy has been working with the Bucks County Believers for a couple years now, and he has been teaching our young players and our newest players the proper form for passing. So take it away, Coach Troy.
My pleasure. You're going to do hello like a telephone? Where's it going to go? And bro, don't forget to pass it on the target on your chest.
Hello, go, bro.
So, Coach Troy, why would we make a target down here at our chest?
Because they'll know the player when I know where to catch it.
So that the passer knows where to pass it. I guess you can bring it in and catch it easier at your chest. Plus, if the target's up at your nose and you miss the ball, that could get pretty bad, right?
Yeah, you get hit in the face.
Hey, let me see how you're holding the football. Oh, right at the laces. Very good. I guess that helps you make a spiral pass.
Yes, it does.
Okay. And remember, you know, we're not only are we teaching the newest and youngest players, you know, now during the pandemic, you know, mom, dad, sister, brother, aunt, uncle, who have never played before, might need to learn some of this stuff. So now we have a nice mantra, and I'll let you guys do it a couple more times here so they see.
Okay.
You'll see it right.
Okay.
You're gonna do like a hello, like a hello, where's it gonna go, and throw.
Hello, go, throw.
Do it one more, do it again. Like hello, where's it gonna go, and throw.
Good job, guys. Thank you. Listen, gang, I want you guys to give this a try. And if you can, see if you can film it. Troy, why don't you show them how we marked it out? Because we didn't, at the time, have a measuring tape.
We did it by...
Take a great big long step with the tallest person in your family. Ready? Go ahead. You count seven for me.
One. Two. Seven
yards. So, you know, even if you don't have a big measuring tape, get a tall person, count out seven. We're going to do 7, 10, and 12. And go ahead and feel free to film that because we may be having a contest. All right, now Neil is going to try the 7-yard pass. You ready, Neil?
Yeah. Hello.
All right, good job. Now Troy is 10 yards away. Boy, you can really see a big difference. Are the bugs bothering you, Troy? Are you okay?
I'm okay.
All right, Neil, ready to go.
Hello, go, go.
Hey, that was good. Now, it got a little bit harder. First, we did 7, Then we did 10. Now Neil is at 12 yards, and that looks pretty hard to me. You gonna give it a try?
Yeah, I'm gonna give it a try.
All right.
Do hello, my guitar, where you gotta go, and bro.
Oh, that was so close.
Hey,
Melissa and Shelly have come to flag football practice since we started, and they know the proper form. Now, we've set up 15 yards, which is really far. So let's see if Melissa can throw it 15 yards and hit a target. Woohoo, that's really close. Hey, I'm glad that you guys were doing our drill today. And you know, I just wanted to remind you, make sure you take your water breaks. It might look cool and windy here, but it's hot. So keep hydrated. Thanks, athletes.
Okay, we have Nick K. Wood. He's gonna try to throw for distance. He's got his fingers on the laces. He's gonna put the ball behind him. He's gonna try to throw it as far and straight as he can. Almost 20 feet.
Almost 20 yards. Almost
20 yards. Okay, now we have Neil up. He's going to try throwing for distance. And he's going to put his fingers on the laces. He's going to put the ball behind him. And he's going to try to throw it as far as he can. Okay, this is Nick Gaywood again. He's going to see how far he can throw for distance. And again, we put our fingers on the laces, put it behind us, and then he's going to throw. Okay, we have Neil going for distance, and he's got his finger.
Woo! The wind took that one too. 35, 36, 13 yards almost. Good job.
Remember, you put your fingers on the laces. Yep, the laces. You put the ball behind you.
Observation the other day, you know, we've been teaching hello, where is it going to go, and throw, and of course that's for skills. In a game situation, you don't want to tell the defense where you're throwing the ball. So that was a good observation. Way to go. Thank you.
He's gonna put his hands on the laces. Can you show us the laces, Nick? He's putting his hands on laces, and then he's gonna put it behind him, and then he's gonna try to throw for distance.
Whoa,
oh, right through the set, right through it.
Hey, it's Coach Kathy. I'm here with Coach Troy and Neil. And you know, it occurred to me that we talked about throwing passes that were 7 yards, 10 yards, and 12 yards, and we didn't really explain why. So I'd like to show you that part. And yes, this is a pizza box. I didn't have a whiteboard, but you know, we're being creative. This is a representation of the football field. And when we start out, we're going to be at the 5-yard line. And we have to get to the 10, 15, to the 20 is the midline. We have to get the ball 15 yards in 4 tries in order to continue keeping the ball. That's the offense. So we have 4 tries to get a first down. And you know, I've seen lots and lots of games where everybody picks their fastest runner and the guy with their biggest arm, and they throw a Hail Mary pass all the way down the field. And that's okay, but we're the inclusion revolution. We would like to see all of our athletes get a chance to play and get a chance to be the quarterback or catch a short pass. So at first especially, we like to focus on these short passes and short plays. Maybe not a competition, but when we first start out training, we're going to try to make sure everybody gets a chance. And that's why we've been focusing on these short passes. So thanks for letting me explain that, and we'll talk to you soon. All right, we're going to show you the hike. If you notice, Neil's got the ball on the ground. The laces are up. Generally, we use both hands, and we pass it back to the quarterback behind us. And in Bucks County and all over the state, we try to say hut one, hut two, hike pretty universally. Go ahead, Troy.
Hut one, hut two, hike.
And Neil's going to step forward there. And now in a game situation, the center, once he's hiked the ball, can step off the line and run out for a pass. Yeah. We did it this way today because there's a camera person and two players, so we kind of had to. So Neil, why don't you come on back? And now we're going to try a little bit different kind of hike. You know, when we first in the state of Pennsylvania started teaching hiking, we only passed it through the legs the way you just saw, but it's kind of evolved to be look a little bit more like college sports and pro sports. And Troy, you can back up even a little bit more, I think. And this would be an example of a shotgun. So you can pretend I'm blowing the whistle.
Up one, up two, hike.
Ah, that's kind of tricky, isn't it? I think that takes some practice. You guys want to do it again?
Yeah.
All right. Usually what the referee will say is ball on the ground. Referee will blow the whistle, and then you'll know that the quarterback can say his cadence.
Hut one, hut two, hike.
Oh, let's try it again, guys. This is not so easy. This takes practice. All right, guys. Ready?
Ready.
Ball on the ground.
Hut one, hut two, hike.
All right, Neil. Very good. Well, hey there. This is Coach Kathy, and thanks for watching Coach Troy, because he worked really hard on preparing that little film you saw about how to throw a football and what's the proper form. He's an athlete that became a coach, so I'm hoping that you all find that real encouraging, because that could happen for you too. Neil, I don't want you to think that you always got to plan a practice in order to practice football, because
get involved with your brother and sister and mom and dad. They'd be happy to
teammate.
Help out.
A teammate?
Yeah.
We're just here at a picnic. This is an indoor picnic because it was really hot outside. So before we get dessert, we're all going to go outside and have a little catch. And we're going to teach Aunt Eileen and our cameraman Pete.
Hello.
Oh, go ahead and say hello.
Oh, hello. Hi.
Now, I guess, Pete, you're actually a football player, so maybe you could teach us a few things, right?
Possibly.
So anyway, we're going to go out and have some fun, and I hope that you will get together with your family and throw the ball around, have some fun too. Thanks for watching.
Why don't you show us what you learned from Coach Troy about hello, go, and throw.
Hello, go, and throw.
That's good. Hello, where's he going to throw? Whoa, that was almost it. There we go. Hello, where's it going to go? And throw.
It's not always good if you're doing a game that the defense sees your point or receiver and might see your receiver is and pick it all.
Well, this is true, but right now it's just our family practicing.
Yeah, no.
She's training. Oh, okay. Everybody who plays catch gets dessert. So I'm glad that we got bounced away from the dinner table and we're having a little throw around. There we go. Thanks.
I hope you and your family can play a little catch too. Have fun. Bye.
Bye.
Hey guys, it's Nicole
and Serena,
and we're so excited to cool down with you. So Woo! Let's get excited for some stretches. All right.
Come back.
All right, first we're gonna start with some arms.
Let's roll out those shoulders a little bit.
Roll them, roll them.
And let's go forward. And then let's go backwards. All right, and let's start with your right arm and swing that across. All right, and switch. And then we'll do up here, bring them up. Let's switch. All right, let's bend down, touch your right toe. And switch. So long to the pain is hard. And then let's bring it to the middle. What's wrong when the days we have are boring? You hold on while the world outside is frozen. Alright, and let's bring it down to the ground, do some on the floor. We'll start with a little butterfly. So put your 2 feet together, knees out like a butterfly, and hold it. And we'll bring our right foot out and stretch. Really try to reach those toes, see how far you can get. And then we'll switch to the left and go as far as you can. And legs together. Last one down here. All right, and let's bring it back up for a couple more here. All right, we're gonna take our right foot and hold. Try to keep balance. You can try to hold your left ear for balance. It helps a little bit. Three more seconds here and we'll switch. 3, 2, 1. To the side, stretch it to the right. And stretch it to the left. All right, guys, that was amazing. We love stretching with you, and we can't wait for more. We love you guys.
Woo! Love you guys.
Woo woo.
Hope to see you next year.